I have the Oppo Reno 2 and I have the Vivo Z1X. Both have great lineage. So I'll start off with this, the Oppo. Now when Reno came out, it became like a subsection for them and they said they'll have more Reno phones and they were very, very successful with that phone. And now comes the Reno 2, but it's not just one. Three different phones came out with the Reno 2 tag. But the real one, the big one, is this one, and we'll only review this one today. We'll get to the other ones very, very soon. So what's the big deal? First of all, the Reno 2 has four cameras at the back. That really is the big game changer. We'll take you through what do those four cameras do. Then a really good battery life, a fantastic screen. It's got optical and electronic image stabilization working together. It's got a hybrid zoom, great looking phone in every which way. So if you really put it all together, the Reno 2 really had big boots to fill, and it does. Here's our very detailed review.
After making heads turn with its optics, Oppo Reno is back. This time the company goes with a family of three phones. But heading this family and the most premium of the trio is the Oppo Reno 2. The price has definitely been stepped up a bit and it now starts at 36,990 rupees. But what else has Oppo amped up here? Let's find out. The shark fin is back. One of the most eye-catching and noticeable things about the Reno series is the shark fin selfie camera that pops out. The Oppo Reno 2 retains this design and we'll come to the selfie prowess of this phone in just a bit. Oppo has ensured this phone looks like a million bucks. We got the luminous black color for review and love the blue LED-like effect the phone had from the back. The back has Corning Gorilla Glass 5 protection while the front of the phone goes with the more resilient Corning Gorilla Glass 6. The front screen of the phone is also every bit stunning. The screen is a large 6.55 inches. It has a dynamic AMOLED display with full HD plus resolution. This is the same display as seen on the latest Samsung Galaxy Note 10. The color reproduction is crisp and the display has very good contrast. Watching videos on this phone is a delight because there is no notch and it is a full screen display. The brightness of the phone can go up to 800 nits, which is great for a phone at this price point. The phone runs on Snapdragon 730G, which is known for its gaming capabilities. This is the same chipset as seen on the more premium Samsung Galaxy A80 phone as well. This chipset in this phone is coupled with an 8GB RAM, which makes it quite a powerhouse. Gaming was great on the Reno 2, although the phone is a bit heavy to hold while gaming. This is probably because of the large battery the Oppo Reno 2 packs in. There's a 4000 mAh battery on board along with Whoop 3.0 charging. The phone lasted us more than a day of heavy use, including gaming. On the software front, the Oppo Reno 2 runs on Color OS 6.1 on Android 9 Pie. The phone has fewer pre-installed apps, and while we scrolled through, the UI felt smooth and fast. The big USP of the Reno series has been the camera, and in particular the zoom. So well, with the Reno 2, Oppo has brought out its big guns. The phone comes with a quad camera setup, all stacked up vertically in a beautiful design at the back. There is a 48 megapixel Sony IMX586 sensor, a 13 megapixel telephoto lens, an 8 megapixel wide angle camera, and a 2 megapixel macro lens. The details in the 48 megapixel shots were impressive. The ultra wide angle can capture an adequately large field of view, but it is the zoom capabilities that this phone comes into its own. There's a 5x hybrid zoom which gave us a clear zoomed in shot, and there is a 20x digital zoom. We took the same subject with this zoom and there wasn't much loss in detail. The ultra dark mode 2.0 is a long exposure mode which can capture bright images in practically any low light situation. The macro lens comes into play when the subject is placed very close to the lens. We got some very detailed shots with this mode. The main lens of the camera packs an optical image stabilization as well. The videos we took on this phone were very impressive and the zoom is supported in video as well. In a world with pop-up and rotating cameras, Reno tries to remain the trendsetter here with a shark fin. The mechanism is smooth and it comes up in an instant. The 16-megapixel front shooter does the job well in good light, but the same can't be said about the phone in low light. The in-display fingerprint scanner was already pretty good in the Reno, but now the Reno 2 comes with fingerprint unlock 3.0, which is much faster to unlock. So does this shark bite the dust? Well, the Oppo Reno 2 comes with an all-rounder camera which can give very versatile shots and even videos, although the selfie camera falls behind in this regard. The phone wins big on design and we love the curved glass body it has, but on other aspects, it compares with the Redmi K20, which is priced much lower, and the Galaxy A80. But if you are all about your pictures and want a phone under 40K, then the Oppo Reno 2 is your best bet.